But he came from a GoFundMe page set up to pay his legal fees, but he was never charged over the egging.
Pharmacists are warning of a flu vaccine shortage, with fears supplies could run out within weeks. It comes as key medical unions slammed the latest government plan to ease pressure on public hospitals ahead of the traditional winter peak period.
A potentially life-saving jab that pharmacists say is in short supply.
I have seen shortages of flu vaccine in the past, but not this early, not in May. For most pharmacies, the wholesalers are now out of that, out of stock.
With the state battling a horror flu season, the Pharmacy Guild claims some chemists can't get enough vaccines.
It's getting quite severe. The community pharmacies' stocks are right down.
The supply warning coming as the Health Minister urged people to get a shot.
The message reiterated by the clinicians this week, it's not too late to get a flu shot. Please, if you haven't been immunised, please be immunised.
Stephen Wade unveiling the government's latest plan to help with hospital demand, a new website for patients.
Very importantly, it's providing advice to people on how to stay well.
It outlines how the government is trying to handle surging demand year round, not just during the usual winter peak, but it hasn't impressed medicos.
This does appear to be propaganda rather than a plan.
Simply having a website will not be enough.
They say with the peak pressure months looming, their calls for new winter demand plans have fallen on deaf ears.
We really do need, as a system and as a community, a coherent plan that addresses accountability, timeframes.
Find some new strategies, find it quickly. Again, look at the bed resourcing and have the ability to flex up those beds.
The opposition claims today's announcement shows the government has failed to adequately prepare for the upcoming peak period.
We've got a government not willing to put any additional resources or effort into managing the surge in demand that we're going to have in our hospitals over the coming months.
Kate Lamb, Nine News.
More than a million South Australians are expected to cash in at this